In this video lesson, you'll learn about the basic terminology and degree measures of angles. Let's start off by looking at the parts of an angle. The point where the two sides of the angle intersect is called the vertex. Angles have an initial side, which is where the angle begins, and they have a terminal side where the angle ends. Angles have direction. So angles that open in a counterclockwise direction are considered to be positive angles. Whereas angles that open in a clockwise direction are considered to be negative angle measures. Next, we're going to look at degree measure, and we know that 360 degrees is equal to one full revolution. So we can convert between degrees and revolutions using that conversion factor. So 360 degrees, we multiply by our conversion factor of one revolution per 360 degrees. We see that 360 and the degree symbol will cancel with 360 and the degree symbol in the denominator, and we're left with one revolution. We could also refer to this as one rotation, one cycle, or one oscillation. Now, if we consider this motion on a circle, what we're saying then is that our object started at a point on the circle and went all the way around the circle. So that's the one revolution, or the 360 degrees of travel. If this was the initial side of the angle opened all the way up until it was all the way around the circle. Now 180 degrees, we can multiply it times the conversion factor, one revolution per 360 degrees. Now we see that the degree symbol will cancel the degree symbol, and 180 goes into 360 twice, so we get left with 1/2 of a revolution. Now if we look at a circle here, and let's say here's our initial side of the angle, there's the point. In this case, that means the point rotated halfway around, and we can see this angle would be 180 degrees, or half of a revolution. Now 40 degrees, if we multiply times the conversion factor, one revolution per 360 degrees, we can see that the degrees in the numerator cancel with degrees in the denominator. Now 40 goes into 360 nine times, so this becomes 1/9 of a revolution. And if we were to look at that on the circle, here's our initial point. we know 40 degrees would be about to here. So what that would mean is the point rotated 1/9 of the way around the circle, or 40 degrees around the circle. Next, we're going to go over the different types of angles we'll see. Back in your geometry class, you probably defined an acute angle as an angle whose measure was less than 90 degrees. Now, in trigonometry, that definition is not sufficient because we can actually have negative angle measures. So we need to define an acute angle as an angle whose measure is between 0 and 90 degrees. So an acute angle would look something like this. And there's our angle measure. Now, a right angle is exactly 90 degrees. And we know that that would look like this. And we indicate a right angle by putting in the perpendicular symbol between the two sides. An obtuse angle has measures between 90 degrees and 180 degrees. So if we were looking at an obtuse angle, it might look something like this, where this is the measure of our angle here. More than 90 degrees, but less than 180 degrees. A straight angle is exactly 180 degrees. So if we look at a straight angle, here's its initial side. That angle opens all the way up until its terminal side forms a line with its initial side. Now, complementary angles are two angles whose measures add up to be 90 degrees. So two angles, we can use this little symbol to indicate the word angles. Two angles that add to 90 degrees. So for example, if we had one angle that was 30 degrees and we had another angle that was 60 degrees, those two angles would be complementary angles because their two angle measures add up to be 90. Supplementary angles are two angles that add up to be 180 degrees. So if we looked at a picture of those, we could say maybe we had an angle that was 50 degrees, and if we had an angle that was 130 degrees, those two angles would be supplementary because they add up to be 180 degrees. Now let's check out this example. If an angle measures X degrees, then your job now is to find the measure of its complement and of its supplement. So the complement means the angle is complementary to X degrees, and supplement means the angle is supplementary to X degrees. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. The complement of X degrees, well, that means that X and that angle have to add up to be 90 degrees. So then that means the other angle must be 90 degrees minus x degrees. And for the supplement, the supplementary angle has to add up to 180 degrees with x, which means the measure of the supplement has to be 180 degrees minus x degrees.